Who's that running down the alley in the dark of Friday night as he zippers up his trousers in the inky slinky light? Why, of course, it's good old Gary leaping over someone's fence. Yes, it's good old Gary Hart. I wouldn't keep you in suspense. He likes going out to parties. He likes being in Rolling Stone. And he ran things for McGovern, so I guess we should have known. He likes warm and willing women. He likes being where they are. He couldn't sing, he couldn't dance, but he just had to be a star. So he went into the politics game. Yes, he went into the politics game. Warren Beatty told him, rookie, you can get a lot of nookie if you get into the politics game. When he made it to the Senate, Gary started making hay. Gary started making nearly everything that came his way. He liked taking a position, but when all is said and done, Gary's favorite position was the missionary one. Kennedy was Gary's hero, and he studied him with care, how he stood and how he walked, and even how he wore his hair. But the thing that moved him most and made him swear he'd never fail, if he made it to the White House, think of all the chicks he'd nail. So he went into the politics game. Sing it. Yes, he went into the politics game. Warren Beatty told him, lookie, you can get a lot of nookie if you get into the politics game. Well, he met her at a party, and her name was Donna Rice. She was Gary's kind of woman. She was pure Miami Vice. She thought he was Gary Collins and could get her on TV. She suggested Monkey Business, and the rest is history. When they caught him making whoopee and the campaign had to cease, Gary went into seclusion. He just had to find some peace. He's been out in Colorado since I can't remember when, but he must be getting horny because he's running once again. Yes, he's running in the politics game. Oh, he's running in the politics game. Warren Beatty told him, rookie, you can get a lot of nookie if you get into the politics game.